यश बागल, एम आई ऑडिबल? बागल,
यस सर।
हाँ, लाउडली।
यस सर।
व्हिच चैप्टर इज गोइंग ऑन? विल यू टेल व्हिच चैप्टर इज गोइंग ऑन? चैप्टर नंबर एट लिस्ट, इफ यू आर नॉट नोइंग नेम नेम ऑफ चैप्टर और यूनिट।
थर्ड नंबर।
हाँ, व्हिच? यस, विच चैप्टर इज गोइंग ऑन? अथर्व, 20 रोल नंबर, रोल नंबर 20। So, good afternoon all. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
So yesterday we have started chapter number 3. What was the name of chapter number 3? What you are observing on the screen?
Analysis of pin joint frames.
Analysis of pin joint frames we have seen. So yesterday we have just started this chapter. What is mean by analysis? What we have seen yesterday? What does it mean by analysis? Study of what?
Study of forces.
Very good. Study of forces. Study of forces in a member, more precisely we can say study of stresses also. So analysis is nothing but study of forces. Pin joint. Pin joint. What is the other name we have seen yesterday?
Hinged joint.
Hinged joint. How many reactions are there for hinged joint?
Two reactions.
Two reactions. Horizontal and vertical. That part is going to rotate around certain axis, so it will not have moment. That also we have seen. Frame means once components are joined together, whatever structure will form, it is called as frame. It is as simple as this. We have seen analysis of pin joint frame. This chapter yesterday we have started. Whatever we are observing on the screen right now, it is a syllabus. So we will not read now this syllabus. In introduction, we have seen a pin joint frame structure is made up of slender. So this word also we have discussed yesterday. What does it mean by slender? Slender is nothing but, here it is given, it is a component for which cross-sectional area dimensions or cross-sectional dimensions are quite smaller as compared to length. In other words, I can say slenders are the lengthy element. Such frames are used as a roof trusses. Trusses, that yesterday this word came a lot of many times. What does mean by truss? Then a frame in which all members lie in. There are two types of frames we can say, or trusses. Which are they? One is plane frame. One is plane frame. And what is other? Can anybody remember?
Space frame.
Space frame. One is plane frame, another one is space frame. So what is plane frame? When all the members lie in single plane. So this, now I will not go in depth. What is plane? So we have discussed a lot many times what is plane. If all the members lie in same plane or unique, even same plane or single plane, I will say, it is called a plane frame. On the other hand, if these are not lying on lying in single plane, it is called as space frame that we have seen. So a famous example of space frame is tripod. So maybe some functions, etc. The tripod you might have seen where camera is there for the video recording, whatever the application. Even this transmission system is also famous example. You might have seen many more times this transmission system, whatever these poles are there, it is consist of number of members. So what is the purpose of trusses, or what is the use of truss? Yesterday we have discussed. What is the purpose to use number of members in a particular frame, we can say? What is the use?
Yesterday we have discussed.
Purpose of truss is nothing but, it is most important. Why trusses are used? To distribute to distribute and to transfer the force and transfer the force. That is the most important thing as per a trusses. These are the famous examples which you are observing on the screen. These are called the trusses. Okay. Thereafter, not to read this, say like, so types of frames we have seen. How many types are there?
Three
types are there. Very good. Which are they?
Perfect,
efficient, and redundant.
Very good. There are three types of the trusses. One is perfect. One is perfect. So to whom we should say perfect? Perfect. Whatever number of members are used in the truss, these are sufficient to take load and transfer the required load. Perfect. Name itself, it is showing perfect. And the relation between member and number of joint, how it is given? What was the equation yesterday? We have seen M is equal to
2J minus 3.
This is the equation. This equation is going to satisfy where M stands for?
Members.
And J stands for?
Joints.
If this equation is going to satisfy, we are calling it as a perfect truss. Second one is deficient. What does it mean by deficient? If number of members used in the trusses are not sufficient or not required, not sufficient, we can say, to transfer the load, then it is called as a deficient member. So what will happen in this case? Whatever deformation of truss will happen. And third one we have seen, what is the third type of a truss?
Redundant.
Third truss is redundant, in which number of members are used more number of members are used in this. So LHS will become more than RHS. So such type of trusses, another name of is what? So in this case, we cannot analyze the truss when number of members are used more. So it is called as which type of structure? Determinate or indeterminate?
Indeterminate.
Such structures become indeterminate. We cannot analyze. Analyze means we cannot find the forces in that we have seen. Then we have seen assumptions in analysis of pin jointed trusses. What are the assumptions? How many assumptions we have seen yesterday?
Four
assumptions. So these are the four assumptions which are used in the analysis of trusses. What is the first? Whatever ends of members are joined, it is joined by what?
Pin connected
or pin jointed, or other name is hinged. It is but obvious these are hinged joint or pin joint. Second one is the loads only acting at where load we are supposing that load is acting?
Joint.
Only at the joint. The load, whatever it is there, we are taking it as only at the joint. Then what is third one? Self weight of the member is negligible. Self weight means we are not considering the
load.
We are not considering the weight of the member. Okay. And last one is member are having either uniform cross section throughout. You see, in general, we are assuming uniform cross section. If not, it is some extra thing we can say. If it is having some varying cross section, then we are supposed to add the load to its at CG, center of gravity. But these are the four simple assumptions in the trusses. Ends of the members are hinged, loads are only at joint, self weight is negligible, members are having either uniform cross section, or if not, we have to give load to its centroid. So 99% or maximum time members we are considering as a uniform cross section. These are the four assumptions. And to analyze the truss, most important thing is nature of forces. So either that force will be, we have discussed yesterday, either that particular force will be
tensile or compressive.
Either it will be tensile or
compressive.
Or it will be compressive. How to decide?
Away from the point.
Tensile means away from the joint.
Away from the joint word is important, not point. Away from joint. If particular force is acting away from the joint, we are saying it as a tensile force. And here I will say towards the joint.
Towards.
If the particular force we are acting, we will show it as towards the joint. It is said that it is a compressive force or compression. and particular member falls under compression, particular member falls under tension, whatever it may be. So that we have seen. Okay, tensile, always we have to remember, tensile away from the joint, compression, compressive force towards the joint. This thing also we have to remember. Next, then afterwards what we have seen, there are three methods actually to analyze the truss. There are how many methods? Three methods. Out of three, for our subject or for our this study, only first two methods are there. First one, method of joint, method of section. So method of joint means what? One by one joint you have to target, or you have to take one by one joint, and by applying the conditions of equilibrium, you can find the forces one by one. So that one problem we have seen today, also one problem we are going to solve. And method of section, so what is there between these two? Once we are going to start this method of section, you will come to know that. What is that? Okay, so method of joint, each and every member you have to analyze. Analyze means find out the force in each and every member. But method of section, a particular member. Section means to cut. Yesterday I have told this word. Take section. Taking the section of object means to cut the object, to slice the object. Either you can say cut or you can say slice. Slice means also to cut. To cut like this. Means required. Not necessary to find force in each and every member. But whatever required is there, you can find like that. Okay, so let us solve one problem today. So yesterday I have told very lengthy problems are there. Lot many equations you have to apply. Okay, this problem we have solved today. This problem would actually I have asked you to solve. If not today, we will solve this. Who will read this problem?
Analyze the truss as shown in following figure. All members are 3 meters long.
Analyze the truss as shown in following figure. All members are 3 meter long. So whatever members are there in this, so all members are 3 meter long. So immediately you should be able to identify. So A, B, C, D, E, F. A, B, C. So C is double. So I will write somewhere here, suppose D. So here I will write suppose D. This D. Okay. ABCD truss. So this truss we are going to analyze. The truss means what? Analyze means what? Finding out
force.
Finding the forces in each member. So first I will ask. So name of the truss is A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Up to G. How many joints and how many force, how many members are there in this? So if I will ask
seven
this
joint.
Simple.
Seven joint.
M is equal to how much? J is equal to how much?
J is equal to 7, sir.
J is equal to 7. Okay. M is equal to? Eleven. So what our equation says, M is equal to 2J
minus 3.
So whether this equation is getting satisfied?
Yes, sir.
11 is equal to 2J means 14 minus 3. 14 minus 3 equal to?
11.
So what is the type of truss?
Perfect
truss. We can say it is a perfect truss. This is for our information. It is a perfect truss. As equation is getting satisfied, it is a perfect truss in solution. Now, in a solution. So, let us say. So, which type of supports? Before that, I will ask. At what point support is given for the truss?
A and E.
What is the type of support? What is the type of support at point A?
Hinge
and roller. How many reactions will be there at point A?
Two reactions
will be there at point A. Very good. So that reactions also we have to find first. So at corner, what I will do? So whatever things we are going to find, that I will write here. So first will be RA, suppose H equal to RA, P equal to then RE equal to this. Again, you can tell now member one by one. So what will be the forces members member in forces? First will be AB.
Yes, sir.
Member AB. That force also we should find. Again, next force will be A point. We will consider. Yep.
AC.
After that, A point is over. B. B point. How many members are there at point B? F.
BC means BC.
Yep. BD and yep. BC. Point B is over. Next, if you go to point C, how many reactions will be there? How many forces? AC over, BC over. Yep.
CD and C.
CD, CD.
Yep. CD. Yep.
D.
C.
CD over CE. Yep. CE. Okay. Next. Point C is over. Point D. Which forces are remained at point D?
DF and DE.
DF, DE.
Okay. Force?
DF.
DF. Force?
DE.
Force DE. See, next, D is over, E, at point E, how many forces are remained?
EF and EG.
Force EF and force?
EG.
Okay, point E is over, point F.
FG.
Yep.
G.
Point F. Any is remaining? At point F. F.
No.
FG. F. FG. So how many forces? These many forces we are supposed to find. How many forces are there, including reactions? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Okay, 14. So obviously 11 members are there. Okay, 11 members, which is, and three? First three? 11 members and first three, what? Reactions? Am I audible? Shubham?
Yes, sir.
First three reactions. Two reactions at point A, one reaction at point E, and three reactions we are supposed to find. Okay, now my question, look at the figure. How many external forces are acting on the truss?
Four.
Four.
How many external forces are acting on the truss?
Four.
Yes.
Yes.
So first task is to calculate reactions. First task is to calculate the reaction. So this, we will say point, I will say suppose here E. Okay, point E, there is a reaction RE, and here again, further, there is one point. So I will show something like this, 20 kilonewton. So this force, again, here, there will be two reactions. Let us say vertical RAP and horizontal RAH. Then at this middle point, between A and C, there will be one force. What will be that force? I am just extending that 40 kilonewton force.
40 kilonewton.
Directly it will come somewhere here. It will come somewhere here at the middle. Then there were another force, 30 kilonewton. 30 kilonewton. So it will come here. 30 kilonewton. So this force. Okay. Again this force. So this force where I should, up to E. So I will show somewhere here that horizontal force, which is that 10 kilonewton. Now I want to find RAH, RAV and RE. These forces I want to find. How to find now? Not forces, reactions I want to find. In more precisely, reactions. Which equation I have to apply now?
Summation
effect
is equal to
zero. Okay, which force I will get if I will apply summation effect is equal to zero?
RAH.
RAH.
What will be the equation? RAH?
Minus 10 is equal to zero.
Minus 10 equal to?
Equal to zero.
Which implies RAH equal to how much?
10
kilonewton. So directly here my first answer will be 10 kilonewton. Okay. So I got this. Next now. Next. Which equation I am supposed to apply?
RA. Summation FY.
Summation FY. is equals to zero.
Now, summation Fy is equal to zero. Tell me now. Rav plus Re.
Minus 40, minus 30, minus 20
equal to zero. So what will be this equation? Rav plus Re equal to
90.
Equal to 90, equation number one. To get either Rav or Re, what I have to do?
Momentum.
Where I have to take moment at A? Which value I will get if I will take moment at A?
Rav.
If I will take moment at point A, which value I will get?
Re.
Correct.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, summation of moment due to all forces at point A equal to zero. So 40 kilonewton force we will take first. 40 kilonewton force. Okay. So 40 kilonewton force, what will be the moment clockwise or anti-clockwise at point A due to 40 kilonewton force?
Clockwise.
So 40 plus, it will come for plus. So this I will do like this. 40 into, what will be the perpendicular distance of line of action of 40 kilonewton force from point A?
1.5.
Very good. It is correct. But how? What will be this angle? 60?
60.
What will be this angle?
30.
So this triangle will become 30, 60, 90. And this side is 3 meter. Diagonal is 3 meter. So opposite side of 30 degree angle is half of the diagonal.
Half of the diagonal.
So it will be 1.5. Next, 30. Whether moment will be clockwise or anti-clockwise due to 30 kilonewton force?
Clockwise.
Again clockwise. So 30 into, what is the distance of 30 kilonewton force from point A?
4.5.
Anybody is having problem in 4.5 distance? 4.5. Next, 10 kilonewton force. How will be the movement at point A due to 10 kilonewton force, clockwise or anti-clockwise? Due to 10 kilonewton force.
Anti-clockwise.
Very good. Anti-clockwise. It will be minus. So minus 10 into, what is the perpendicular distance between point A and line of action of 10 kilonewton force? Means this height of triangle you have to find. Or opposite side of 60 degree angle. How? What it will be? Under root 3/2 diagonal. Under root 3/2 of diagonal. Are you knowing or not this? Height we have to find, no? Why any problem? Ha.
2.5.
How come?
Height.
Under root 3/2 into 3. How much it is coming?
2.5, sir. 2.6, sir, approximately.
So let us, I will write this. Under root 3/2 into 3. So minus 10, it is again minus I have written. Then minus Re. Minus Re into perpendicular distance. Perpendicular distance is how much? From point A, roll number 3. What is the perpendicular distance of RE from point A?
6 meters.
Correct. Next, 20 kilonewton. How it will be? Clockwise or anti-clockwise?
Clockwise.
Clockwise.
Clockwise. Positive or negative?
Positive.
Positive.
Positive. So 20 into
9.
9.
20 into 9 equal to 0. From this you can calculate RE. So only RE is the unknown. First tell me what is the value of RE. So I'll calculate the value of RE. First, you should go for calculation immediately. What is value of RE? 62 roll number. Sir. Salagar.
Yes, Salagar. Sir.
How much it is?
58.16.
One answer is coming 58.16. Any other got some answer? 58.16 kilonewton.
16. Yes, sir.
Next, RE is over from equation 1. From equation 1, what is the value of RAV?
31.84.
Two Newton. How much?
31.84.
84 kilonewton. This is the value. So only we have found out reactions till now. Only reactions we have found out. So shall I erase this? So this is basic. We have already solved these many problems. So I will erase this now. Likewise, only you have to find reactions. So actual problem is still not started. Actual problem is not started yet. So now what to do? Which method we are using to analyze the truss? Method of?
Lemmas.
Which method we are using?
Joint.
Method of joint we are using. One by one joint you have to see. One by one joint you have to take into consideration and we have to find. Okay. So first joint. Let us consider which joint we will take. While selecting joint, what care we have to take? Yesterday I have told. What care we have to take?
Number of unknowns,
not more than 2. Very good. Number of unknowns should not be more than 2. Okay. Maximum 2 unknowns we have to consider. So, which joint we will consider now?
A.
Solution?
A, sir. A.
Okay. Let us consider joint A. So, I will write here joint A. Joint A. What will be the FBD? FBD of joint A. FBD of joint A. So here, if I will write, I will draw point A. How many forces reactions are there? One is vertical, RAV. RAV. In this direction, which reaction is there? RAH. Now, force in member AB. So how we are going to assume, suppose, this force. So in this direction, if I'm going to assume away from the joint, let us assume away from the joint. Means what will be the nature we have assumed here?
Tensile.
We have assumed it as a tensile. Similarly, let us assume from this, choice is yours, how you are going to assume. Let us assume tensile or compressive. Choice is yours.
Tensile.
Again tensile. If you want tensile, no problem. Again, we will assume it as a tensile. Yep. What will be the name? Yep, AC. Both we have assumed as a tensile. Correct. So one is horizontal and one is inclined one. So now from point A, at joint A, these two forces we have to find. These two forces. Getting. So which equations we are now here? Moment equation is not possible. Are you getting? There is only one point, and from this point only, all forces are passing. Hence, if at all we are going to apply moment equation, whether it will work, moment equation? Moment equation, whether it will work?
No.
So what we have to do?
Summation fx is equal to zero.
Who will tell summation fx is equal to zero equation?
RAH plus RAH.
RAH value we are knowing, no?
Yes.
Ten. It is there. Plus. FAC we are not knowing. We are supposed to calculate FAC. Then calculate. FAB
plus FAB into cos 60
plus FAB into cos 60 equal to zero. Okay, this will be the equation. So from this FAC, what is the value of cos 60? Plus, what is value of cos 60?
0.5.
Yep, AB equal to, what will be equal to?
Minus 10,
equation number one, I will say. Next, summation FY is equal to zero. Who will tell equation? Summation FY is equal to zero.
RAB.
RAV will be positive. What is its value? RAV we have calculated.
31.84.
Next.
Plus FAB into sin 60.
Plus FAB into
sin 60.
Next. Anything?
No.
From this, which value we will get?
FAB.
Equal to calculate now, and you tell me, is it positive or negative?
-36.76
kilonewton. What negative sign indicate? Yep, AB.
Compressive.
What it indicate? Negative sign. It is there, negative sign. It means whatever we have assumed. Whatever we have assumed, tensility, that force is not tensile, but it is compressive. But it is compressive. So here I will write now. What is its value? 76 kilonewton. In bracket I will write C. Compressive. We have assumed a tensile, but it is compressive. If this value you are going to put in equation 1, tell me value of FAC from equation 1. FAC. Put same value. In equation 1 and tell me what is value is. Yep, AC. Same value, -36.76.
8.38.
Positive? Is it positive?
Yes, sir.
How much it is? Yep, AC.
8.38
positive kilonewton. So FAC 8.38 kilonewton. Again, I will write tensile. 8.38 kilonewton tensile. Likewise, I will write. So two forces we found here. Yep, AB, yep, AC. Joint A is over. Any so problem?
28.38.
Yes, sir.
28.38.
8.38. Whether you have kept a plus or minus. Yep, yep, yeah. Like same value you have to take in this above equation, minus only. I will calculate. So minus 10. Minus 10. Minus 0.5 into again minus 36.76. 8.38 only.
Yep.
Kuna chale 28. Any problem? Kuna chalta 28.
Let me 36 plus ghetle mo
yaltas. Plus nahi minus ghetsa hayatas.
Yes sir.
8.38. Tensile. So joint A is over. Joint A is over. Okay. So next joint we will go now, which will be the next joint. Likewise only you have to proceed. So okay. Next joint now. So what I will do, I will take next joint. Meanwhile, this FBD of A, I will retain as it is. So if you will take next joint B, how many unknowns will be there in joint B? FBD I have retained as it is. Consider now joint B. Consider joint B. How many unknowns will be there at joint B?
Two.
Which will be two forces at point B?
BD and BC.
How many total forces will be there at joint B? FBD I will draw. FBD of B. See here, FBD of B. So point B is here. Point B is here. Okay. So which force is applying? So just a bit. Which force is there?
40 kilonewton.
One force is there as a 40 kilonewton. Okay. Next. Now joint AB. Force AB. How it is? Compressive or tensile? This force.
Compression.
Means it will be towards the joint or away from the joint?
Towards the joint.
It should be towards the joint. And now, what is its value? We found out 36.76. Then horizontal force. Let us assume we want to find know this force. So how we have to assume compressive or tensile? Choice is yours. How we should assume it?
Tensile.
Okay, you want a tensile? So let us assume it as a tensile. Yep, B, D. Next one. Yep, B, C will be for something like this. How to assume? Tensile or compressive? Choice is yours. How to assume tensile. This force?
Tensile.
Again, tensile. Tensile, you are a... Want again tensile. So let us assume it as a tensile once again. Yep, BC. So how many forces are acting at point B?
Four forces.
Out of that, how many are unknown?
Two.
Okay. Out of that, what is the angle made by 36.76 force and force F BC with the horizontal?
60.
Angle made by both these forces with the horizontal is 60. So which equation we will apply? Which equation we should apply? Either anyone, summation fx or summation fy. Both we have to apply. Summation fx is equal to 0. Who will tell? First, 36.76 plus or minus?
Plus.
Plus 36.76 was 60. Yep, BD plus or minus?
Plus.
Again plus. Next, FBC plus or minus?
Plus.
Plus FBD. Sorry, FBC.
Yep.
Into cos 60.
Cos 60.
Equal to zero. So here I will write FBD. FBD plus cos 60 0.5.
Yes.
FBC. Calculate this value. Equal to, now I will write equal to this minus, it will become a minus 36.76 cos 60, means half, 18 point how much?
38.
Minus 18 point 38.
Yes.
Equation number one. Let us apply summation fy is equal to zero. Summation fy is equal to zero. But tell me, who will tell value? Equation minus?
Minus 40. Plus FAB into sin 60.
FAB, where is FAB?
Minus. Sorry.
This FAB, how we have assumed that FAB came compressive, 40. No? Means towards, yes, the sir. Joint or towards the joint?
Towards the joint.
Correct. Huh? Yep, AB. Plus. Is plus it coming plus or minus?
Plus.
Plus. 36.76. Sine or cos?
Sine.
60.
Minus FBC.
Minus
FBC into sine 60.
Minus FBC into?
Sine 60.
Sine 60 equal to zero. From this, which force you will get?
FBC.
Very carefully you should calculate. Is it coming positive or negative? FBC. Very carefully. Calculate. Minus 40 plus 36.76 sine 60.
Minus 9.42.
Divided by sine 60. Minus
9.42.
Very good. Minus 9.42 is the correct answer. Minus 9.42 kilonewton. Why? What minus sign indicate? Minus
compressive.
How we have assumed FBC tensile, but actually how it is?
Compressive.
So here, where is FBC? So it is 9.42. Kilonewton, in bracket I will write compressive.
Sir,
positive.
Check kara zara. Positive at least.
No. Minus FBC. Na minus FBC tumhi RHS la ghetla. Te zala positive. Ikadchi term negative jenar na minus 40 plus 36.76 sin 60. Te ali negative. Divide by sin 60. Again negative. Check calculation once again.
Yes.
From equation one. From equation one, which value you are going to get?
FBD.
From equation one, FBD. Tell me the value of FBD.
Minus 13.67.
Minus 18.38. FBC is again. So minus, it will become 0.5 into 9.42. So how much it is? Minus?
Minus 13.67.
13?
13.67.
FBD?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Are you taking FBC positive or negative in that?
Negative.
Then negative. Check once again how it is coming.
Minus is it, sir?
Huh?
Minus it is, sir.
Barabar hai minus, pan value kiti thi FBD.
Minus 13.67.
13.67.
1 minute, I will check once again. My value is coming from equation 1. This RHS is how much? Minus 18.38. Minus 18.38. okay, minus this 0.5 FBC, it will go to right hand side again, it will become positive. Very good.
Yes.
Positive, no? 0.5 into
9.42.
How much it is coming?
Minus 13.77.
Correct, correct. FBD, again it is coming minus 13.67. So again minus indicate what we have assumed FBD tensile. So it is compressive again. Again it is compressive means 13.67 kilonewton. Again it is compressive. It is compressive. Huh? Are you getting? Likewise we have to find. So whatever our, if negative it come, it comes negative, it means nature we have to change. This is point number which B over, no? Now let us see point number C. Shall we go next? Next means same problem.
Yes, sir.
Point C. Are you getting? Such yes. Problem will be, it was asked for 12 to 13 mark, maybe 14-15. Very lengthy problem.
Sir, Lamy's theorem open hota hai nikal.
Lamy's theorem 4 forces hai ki kaise vaparayche. At point A, how many forces are there? 4. At point B, 4. For Lamy, how many forces are required to apply?
3
forces are not there. Next point C. Point C. How many unknowns are there at point C?
2.
Whether we found a FAC? FAC we found out. Okay.
Yes.
FAC we found out. FBC?
Yes.
FBC? Yes, we found out. Yes. Then what will be the unknowns at point C?
2.
So I will write here
C
joint.
And C.
Joint C. So which will be the unknown at point? So here I will write a. So horizontal force. What is the nature of force AC? Force AC, tensile, no?
Tensile.
Tensile means towards the joint or away from the joint?
Away from the joint.
Away from the joint means it will be something like this.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. So how much value it is? Yep. AC 8.38. Correct. Point C. Then. FCE we have to assume. FCE, how we have to assume? Compressive or tensile?
Compressive.
Compressive. Let us assume compressive. One answer came as a compressive. So I will assume as a compressive. FAC. So whether we found FCD, so it will be something like this. FCD. We have not found out. So how to assume its nature? FCD. Compressive or tensile?
Tensile.
Okay, tensile. So away from the joint, tensile. Yep, C, D. Again, here, which force will be there in this direction? Yep.
BC.
Yep, BC. What is the nature of that force? Yep, BC.
Compressive.
Compressive means towards the joint or away from the joint?
Towards the joint.
What is its value?
9.42.
So how many forces are acting at point C?
Four forces.
Four. Out of four forces, how many forces are known to us?
Two.
So which equation we will apply now? Tell me. Summation
Fx is equal to zero.
Summation Fx is equal to zero. Tell me the equation. Minus 8.38 minus FAC.
Plus FCD into cos 60.
FCD into cos
60.
9.42 plus or minus?
Plus.
It is going towards positive x axis. 9.42
into cos 60.
Into cos 60 equal to 0. Okay. So FCD, what is value of cos 60? 0.5?
Yes.
0.5 FCD. Okay. Minus FAC equal to how much? Tell me this constant. 9.42 cos 60. So it will go to this side, it will become negative. So plus 8.38. Tell me, what will be the constant? 8.38 minus 9.42 cos 60.
3.67.
Very good. 3.67. Equation number one. Now which equation we should apply?
Summation
f y is equal to zero. Tell me. So both horizontal force will not come, no? So yep. 9.40, is it? It will be negative 9.42.
Yes,
sir. Sine 60.
Sine 60.
FCD. Whether it will be positive or negative?
Positive.
FCD. Sine
60.
Sine 60 equal to zero. From this, which value we will get?
FCD.
FCD. Let's calculate FCD. Calculator should be in your hand.
9.42.
Positive or negative?
Positive.
So how we have assumed a nature FCD?
Tensile.
And it is coming positive. It means 9.42 FCD. Where it is? 9.42. So I will not write unit. Directly I will write tensile. Whatever we have assumed, it is correct. 9.42. Putting this value in equation one. From equation one. Which value we will get? FAC. Calculate FAC.
1.04.
Positive or negative?
Positive.
1.04. कौन सांगते हैं? शुभम सांगता है क्या?
No sir.
Then Sridhar.
Yes sir.
What is value?
1.04.
1.04. Any other? 38.
Yes sir. 1.04.
Plus sir. Minus.
Plus.
Plus.
Plus means how nature we have assumed for FAC.
Compressive.
Again, it came positive. Means what will be the nature of force in FAC?
Compressive.
FAC, how come?
Tensile.
No, positive. Which force we found out?
FAC.
Sorry. FAC, not. From equation one, which force?
FCD, sir.
FAC, already we found, no? This equation, something gone wrong. C point, CE should be there. CE. Here. C. Are you getting? Where it is? This force. Point C we have considered, no? So this force, which will be this force? Horizontal?
FCE, sir.
FCE. It should be FCE. That's why I'm telling here. It should be FCE. C. FCE. So here again it will become FCE. Where here? Again here it will become FCE. Where it is again equation? Huh? Here FCE. FCE. How much it is? FCE. Here FCE.
1.04.
Again heater. 1.04. Again, it is positive. So, what nature we have assumed for FCE force?
Compressive.
So, again, it is coming positive, means again same 1.04 kilonewton. Again, it is compressive. So, how many forces we found and how many remained? At point C, over. Next joint. Which joint we will take next?
Sir, tensile.
Kuta?
Compressive means negative, it is not like that.
Whatever we have assumed, just assume केलेला आहे, त्याचा जर negative आलं तर त्याचं नेचर बदलायचं लाईक दिस. निगेटिव्ह म्हणजे कॉम्प्रेसिव्ह आणि पॉझिटिव्ह म्हणजे टेन्साइल. दिस लॉजिक इज नॉट करेक्ट. मी काय म्हणतोय, जसं आपण अज्युम केलंय, मी आता अज्युम काय केलंय, एफ सी फोर्स हा डावीकडे जातो, इट इज गोइंग टुवर्ड्स लेफ्ट हँड साइड. मी अज्युम केलं होतं तसंच आलं ते एफ सी तसे वॉट एव्हर आय हॅव अज्युम्ड लाईक दॅट ओनली इट हॅज केम. दॅट्स व्हाय इट इज
राईटकडे जातोय असं केलं सर.
राईटकडे जातोय
8.38.
मग या इक्वेशन मध्ये काय होईल मग एपेक्स मध्ये? मग इथं मग राईट कडे जातोय जर असं अज्युम केलं असतं तर इथं पॉझिटिव्ह आला असते किंवा इथे इथं
8.38 पॉझिटिव्ह येते ना सर?
नाही पॉझिटिव्ह निगेटिव्ह. जर एखादा फोर्स जर निगेटिव्ह आला, आन्सर जर निगेटिव्ह आला तर त्याचं नेचर अपोजिट करायचं, एवढं लक्षात ठेवा.
पॉझिटिव्ह चालतं सर ती.
पॉझिटिव्ह आला याचा अर्थ आपण नेचर जे डिसाइड अज्युम केलेलं आहे ते बरोबर आहे. निगेटिव्ह आला याचा अर्थ आपण
8.38 ची चूक.
काय झालं मी थोडक्यात सांगतो लॉजिक काय आहे. लॉजिक, जर एखादा फोर्स हा निगेटिव्ह आला तर आपण जो अज्युम केला त्याच्या बरोबर अपोजिट नेचर घ्यायचं, आणि जर फोर्स पॉझिटिव्ह आला तो कॉम्प्रेसिव्ह अज्युम केलेला असू द्या किंवा टेन्साइल अज्युम केलेला असू द्या, जर अज्युम केलं जर आन्सर आपलं पॉझिटिव्ह आलं तर अज्युम केलेलं आहे तसं कंटिन्यू करायचं. जर
0.38 चं अज्युम केलेलं तिकडची डायरेक्शन तुम्ही उलटी डायरेक्शन दिली.
कुठली म्हणताय?
8.38 टेन्साइल घेतलेलं आपण.
एसी थांबा, हा एसी फोर्स एसी म्हणताय का? फोर्स एसी आपण कॉम्प्रेसिव्ह केलता, पण इथे लिहिताना मी काय लिहिलंय बघा, एफ एसी 8.38 किलो न्यूटन टेन्साइल म्हणजे अवे फ्रॉम द जॉईंट. तो सध्या टेन्साइल आलेला आहे याचा अर्थ तो अवे फ्रॉम द जॉईंट आहे, म्हणून मी दाखवताना अवे फ्रॉम जॉईंट दाखवलेला बघा हे एफ बी डी मध्ये. येते का लक्षात तुमच्या?
एसी मध्ये आलता ना ते.
हा
पॉइंट ए ला टेन्साइल होता म्हणल्यावर सी ला कसा?
पॉइंट ए ला बरोबर आहे, पॉइंट सी ला पण तो टेन्साइलच असेल अवे फ्रॉम द जॉईंट. अवे फ्रॉम द जॉईंट पॉइंट ए ला अवे फ्रॉम द जॉईंट, पॉइंट सी ला पण अवे फ्रॉम द जॉईंट. दॅट्स ऑल लाईक दिस. व्हेरी लेंथी प्रॉब्लेम. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट डी. Which point we will take next? Point D. हा शेवटचाच प्रॉब्लेम घेऊया. लॉट ऑफ टाइम इट विल टेक, ऑलमोस्ट 1.5 hours रिक्वायर्ड टू सॉल्व वन प्रॉब्लेम. सो इट विल सॉल्व फर्स्ट. ओके, सो ऍट पॉइंट डी हाऊ मेनी अननोन्स आर देअर? ट्राय टू सॉल्व फर्स्ट. आय कॅन अंडरस्टँड दिस इज युअर अवर लास्ट लेक्चर, टुडेज लास्ट लेक्चर, बट स्टील वी हॅव टू सॉल्व. हा पॉइंट डी, or I will say joint D, not
joint.
Joint D. How many unknowns are there at point, at the joint D?
Two.
How many total forces are there at point D?
Five.
So one vertical force, how much it is?
30 kilonewton.
Okay, now BD force. Force in member BD. आता लक्षात ठेवायचं, वेदर इट इज कॉम्प्रेसिव्ह ऑर टेन्साइल, बीडी मधला आपण कॅल्क्युलेट
कॉम्प्रेसिव्ह.
मग मी आता नेचर दाखवताना तो कॉम्प्रेसिव्ह आहे टुवर्ड्स पॉइंट डी आय हॅव टू शो, ऑर अवे फ्रॉम द पॉइंट डी आय हॅव टू शो?
टुवर्ड्स
पॉइंट डी आय हॅव टू शो टुवर्ड्स. ओके, सो हाउ मच इट इज? 13.67 असं दाखवायचं बघा, ते कॉम्प्रेसिव्ह आलेला आहे म्हणून. नेक्स्ट CD force, whether I have calculated CD force? 9.42.
Yes.
Calculate केलेलं आहे 9.42.
Yes.
Whether it is tensile or compressive?
Tensile.
Tensile म्हणजे towards the point का away from the point?
Away from the point.
Away from the point. So how much it is? 9.42. Next. This is over. Next. DE. Point D. इकडं पॉइंट फोर्स डी आपण कॅल्क्युलेट केलाय का? नाही केला. हाऊ टू अज्युम नाऊ दिस फोर्स डी? कॉम्प्रेसिव्ह. शाल अज्युम कॉम्प्रेसिव्ह मीन्स टुवर्ड्स द पॉइंट.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And what about DF force? Force DF horizontal. How I have to assume? Compressive or tensile?
Tensile.
Let us assume tensile. You want tensile? Let us assume tensile. Here DE. Here force. I will assume F. DF. F D. Sorry, F no.
Yes, F D F.
Yep, D.
Yep.
Yep.
Yep. So how many forces are there? Five. Out of that, how many are known to us?
Three.
So we can calculate two forces. Apply. Summation apex equal to zero. Tell me this value. Apex.
13.67
plus again. DF.
Yep, DF.
Yep,
DF. Yep, DF. Correct. Next. 9.42 minus or plus?
9.42.
Minus 9.42 was?
Cos 60.
Cos 60. What about F, DE?
Minus F, DE into cos 60.
Minus F, DE into?
Cos
60 equal to 0. So what equation this will become? Just tell me now. F, D, F, minus F, D, E, into 0.5. Into 0.5. So this value you told, tell me, total value. If it will go to this side, it will become positive. 9.42 into cos 60. Minus 13.67.
Minus 8.96.
Yes, sir. Equation number one. Summation f y is equal to 0. Summation f y is equal to 0. Who will tell? At point D, huh? Minus 30. Okay, then 9.42, whether it will be positive or negative?
Negative.
9.42, sine or cos?
Sine.
Sine 60. Again, this f d, positive or negative?
Positive.
F, D.
Sine 60.
Equal to?
Zero.
Equal to 0. From this, F, D. F, D. Tell me value of F, D.
Plus
44.06 kilonewton. So how nature we have assumed F DE. Now F DE
compressive.
F DE we have assumed it as a compressive and it came positive. That means it is compressive only. 44.06. It is compressive. Okay, next from equation one. From equation one, which value you will get from equation one?
Yep, DF.
Calculate this value. Yep, DF. So -8.96.
13.07.
1 minute. 44.06. Into 0.5. 13.07. Very good. 13.07. How we have assumed a F, D, F?
Tensile.
How answer came over, plus or minus?
Plus.
Means what is the nature of F, D, F then?
Tensile
only. Because whatever we have assumed, it is correct. 13.07. 13.07, I will write tensile like this. Are you getting? So where we came up to joint number 1, 2, 3, 4, fourth. Then which is the next joint?
E.
Only three forces are remained now. Only three forces. Which next joint we will take?
E.
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 So, try to give attention, because almost 80% problem is over. Only last 20%. It's my humble request. Otherwise, from tomorrow again, from point E, how many forces will be there at point E? So if I will here only E, point E, there will be one reaction. Whether we have calculated that reaction, R E.
Yes.
15.16. So CE force in member CE, whether we have calculated? Yes. 1.04. How it is? Tensile or compressive?
Compressive.
So it will be towards the joint.
Okay.
So 1.04. Then EG, whether force EG we have calculated?
No.
No. So how we will assume EG?
Tensile.
Okay, you want to have a tensile, so I will give as a tensile EG. Next, force EF. Whether we have calculated force EF?
No, sir.
No.
How it will be? How we are going to assume? Choice is yours.
Compressive.
Tensile or compressive?
Compressive.
Okay, compressive. Yep. EG. Sorry, EF, no?
Yes. Yep.
Which force is remainder? Yep. DE or ED? Yep. DE or ED?
So,
DE. Okay. What is its nature? What is its value?
Compressive 44.06.
Compressive means towards the joint. Compressive means towards the joint. How much it is? 44.06. So which is this point? Point D, no?
E.
E, no?
Yes.
E point, okay. This is point E. Now, again, we have to apply same equations. Summation Fx is equal to 0. Try to tell the equation. Summation Fx, we will tell. 1.04 plus or minus?
Plus.
1.04. Yep, EG. Plus or minus?
Yep, EG.
Yep, EG. Next. Yep, EF.
Minus.
Yep,
EF.
Minus
EF. Minus EF.
Into
cos 60. Next. 44.06. Plus or minus?
Plus
44.06 was 60 equal to 0. So what will be the equation? Yep, EG minus yep,
into
0.5, no?
Yes, sir.
Equal to now this constant value, you tell me constant. What will be the constant value? Minus 44.06. Cos 60 minus 1 minus 0.04 minus 23.07.
Yes, sir.
Minus 23.07.
Equation number 1. Summation Fy is equal to 0. Fy is equal to 0. Who will tell equation? 18.16. Minus yep, EF, sine or cos?
Sine.
44.06 plus or minus?
Minus.
44.06 sine?
60.
Equal to 0. Which value you are going to get from this? Yep.
EF.
Try to calculate this value. Thank you. 23.09 plus or minus?
Plus.
Plus.
Plus. Plus. Very good. 23.09 kilonewton. So how we have assumed EF?
Tensile.
Neat baga, 38. Yep, EF.
Compressive.
आपलं उत्तर कसं आलेलं पॉझिटिव्ह का निगेटिव्ह
पॉझिटिव्ह
याचा अर्थ काय पॉझिटिव्ह आला याचा अर्थ काय अज्यूम केलेलं
बरोबर आहे
तुम्ही काय अज्यूम केलं इट डझंट मॅटर कॉम्प्रेसिव्ह ऑर टेन्सल इफ युअर आन्सर इज पॉझिटिव्ह मीन्स युअर अझम्पशन इज करेक्ट सो एफ इज कॉम्प्रेसिव्ह सो 23.09 कॉम्प्रेसिव्ह नेक्स्ट From equation 1, which value you will get? Same value you have to put in equation 1. From equation 1. Tell me the value of FEG. FEG. Now you
minus
calculate.
11.52.
Minus?
11.52.
11.52.
Yes.
Any other?
54.
Okay, 54, 52. Okay, 11 is correct. Minus 11.5. Up to this, it should be correct. Minus 11.52 for no difference, not much. But up to minus 11.5, is it correct?
Yes, sir.
So how our answer came negative? What it indicate? How we have assumed FEG?
Tensile.
We have assumed a tensile, but our answer came negative. What does it indicate?
Compressive.
That force is compressive. So FEG. Where is FEG? So I will write here 11.52 in bracket. What I should write now?
Compressive.
Very good. Compressive. So likewise, I have to write compressive. Okay. These many forces we have calculated. So last force is remained, which is that force?
FG.
Force
G.
Force FG. That we will calculate now. So which joint we should consider?
Yes.
Yeah.
Let us consider any you can calculate, no problem. Ha. Joint. Now here I will not write now. Directly now. Only one unknown is there. Point F. Yep, no. So this force is, which is force yep, sorry, 10 kilonewton. So whether we are knowing force df or fd?
Yes, sir.
How much it is?
13.07.
Fd, tensile, it is there?
Yes, sir.
How much it is? 13.07. So what is this value? Here I will draw this force 10. Okay, again here point F. Here 13 point, how much tell me?
13.07
from point this one, one force, and here there is another force. Whether we are knowing force EF,
yes,
how it is compressive or tensile?
Compressive.
What is its value?
23.09.
Okay, and we are supposed to find which force? Force FG, no?
Yes, sir.
How we are going to assume? How I should assume? You tell me.
Compressive.
Inside.
Compressive.
Inside.
Ha. Rule number 11. How I should assume?
Compressive.
Okay, you want compressive, I will assume compressive. Force, which force? FG. Ha. Only what is unknown? How many forces are acting at point F? Rule number 3. How many forces are there at point 3? At point F.
4.
Kite to? Rule number
3.
4. 4. Which is unknown force at point F? Avinash. अविनाश अविनाश ओके सो व्हिच इक्वेशन वी विल अप्लाई समेशन एफ एक्स और एफ वाई
एफ वाई
एफ वाई सर
वाई एफ वाई
हॉरिजॉन्टल
हॉरिजॉन्टल फोर्स
हॉरिजॉन्टल कैलक्युलेशन कमी होते तुमच्या भाषेत कैलक्युलेशन कमी होते हॉरिजॉन्टल फोर्सेस येत नाही सांगा आता इक्वेशन समेशन एफ वाई इज इक्वल टू 23.09 प्लस का मायनस
प्लस
23.09 साइन का कॉस
साइन
60 एफ जी प्लस का मायनस
प्लस
प्लस सर फर्स्ट इयर मध्ये लेक्चर घेतो ऑल इंडिया परमनंट येऊन जातो येऊन जातो हा एफ एफ जी वेदर इट विल प्लस और मायनस
प्लस
प्लस एफ एफ जी साइन का कॉस
साइन
60
साइन 60 इक्वल टू झिरो फ्रॉम दिस कॅल्क्युलेट एफ एफ जी
मायनस
23.09 व्हेरी गुड तुम्हाला उशीर झालेला आहे त्याच्यामुळे लगेच सांगितलं व्हाट मायनस मायनस साइन इंडिकेट
ओवर अजम्पशन इज रॉंग
आवर अजम्पशन इज रॉंग देन व्हाट इज द नेचर ऑफ एफ एफ जी
टेंसाइल
वी हैव अज्यूम्ड कॉम्प्रेसिव बट इट इज टेंसाइल सो आई विल राइट 23.09 दिस इज आवर आंसर सो होप यू विल टेक अ डीप स्लीप टुडे लॉट ऑलमोस्ट 1 hour and 17 minutes it has taken to solve this problem. Okay. This one is our type number one. This is the procedure, method of joint. Any problem, any suggestion? If not, we will stop. Somebody has to take screenshot and can anybody send to me? Yes, so sir. That I will.
Yes, sir.
Somebody. So I will write here my, already it is written. Still I will write here my number. You please send it to me. Because almost 1 hour and 17 minutes it has taken to solve this problem. Okay, I have written here number. You please send me screenshot. Shall we stop?
Yes, sir.
We will stop. Sorry for late. It's too late. Okay. Thank you very much. Any problem? Any suggestion? You can ask. 1 minute.
No, sir.
No, then no, thank sir. You very much. Enjoy the day. Thank you very much once again.
सर
हाँ
टेस्ट नहीं है ना
कसली हो
चैप्टर टेस्ट
गिव एक एक दोन दिवस कोणी सांगितली होती का
टाइम टेबल मध्ये उदय सर
उदय सर
कसली तो कुठला टाइम